एचसी वर्मा चैप्टर 10 क्वेश्चन नंबर 36। द पुलिस सोन आर आइडेंटिकल इच हैविंग रेडियस आर एंड मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया आई। फाइंड द एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ द ब्लॉक्स। लेट द एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ द ब्लॉक्स बी ए एंड द एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ द पुलिस बी अल्फा। सिंस द रेडियस ऑफ बोथ द पुलिस आर आर, ए मस्ट बी इक्वल टू आर इंटू अल्फा और अल्फा इज इक्वल टू ए बाई आर। इफ यू डू नॉट नो द रिलेशन बिटवीन द एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन एंड द लीनियर एक्सेलरेशन, watch our video explaining this relation. The link for the video is shown on the screen and given in the descriptions below. Also, let us assume the tension in the segment of the string between the block on the left and the pulley be T1, tension in the segment of the string between the pulleys be T2, and tension in the segment of the string between the block on the right and the pulley be T3. Let us draw the free body diagram of the block on the left. The gravitational force of capital M into G acts on it in vertically downward direction. Tension T1 pulls the block upward and the block is moving downward with acceleration A. From this FBD, we get capital MG minus T1 is equal to capital M into A. In the free body diagram of the pulley on the left, tension T1 pulls the pulley downward while tension T2 pulls it towards right. The pulley is accelerating in anti-clockwise direction with angular acceleration alpha about its center. Since the radius of the pulley is r, the torque due to T1 about its center is T1 into r in anti-clockwise direction and torque due to T2 is T2 into r in clockwise direction. Hence, net torque due to these tensions is T1 into r minus T2 into r in anti-clockwise direction, which must be equal to moment of inertia into alpha. If you do not know how to calculate torque, you may watch our video on calculation of torque. The link for the video is shown on the screen and given in the descriptions below. Putting alpha is equal to A by R, we get T1 minus T2 into R is equal to I into A by R, or T1 minus T2 is equal to I by R square into A. In the free body diagram of the second pulley, tension T2 is pulling the pulley towards left and tension T3 is pulling it downwards. The pulley is rotating in anti-clockwise direction with angular acceleration alpha. Net torque on the pulley is T2 into R minus T3 into R, which must be equal to I into alpha. Taking R common and putting alpha is equal to A by R, we get T2 minus T3 into R is equal to I into A by R, or T2 minus T3 is equal to I by R square into A. Finally, in the free body diagram of the block on the right, gravitational force of Mg pulls the block downward, tension T3 pulls it upwards, and the block is moving upward with acceleration A. Net force in upward direction, that is T3 minus Mg, must be equal to Ma. Adding all these equations, we get capital Mg minus T1 plus T1 minus T2 plus T2 minus T3 plus T3 minus Mg is equal to capital M into A plus I by R square into A plus I by R square into A plus Ma. Simplifying, we get capital M minus M into G is equal to capital M plus 2I by R square into A. This implies A is equal to capital M minus M into G divided by capital M plus 2y divided by R square. This is our answer. In order to request solution to any question from HC Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.